are sowing the seeds of what I believe ultimately will determine whether this enterprise will succeed or not. Now, the decision to establish a continental free trade area for Africa was indeed a historic one, because it is a major step in consolidating the integration agenda for Africa. But I must say that whilst there are many converts to this concept of the CFTA, there are an equal number of doubting Thomases. And I'm sure there may be some actually with us in this room. And they are doubting Thomases for a number of reasons. But I look at this from this point of view, that in actual fact, whether there will be challenges or not, as a continent, we have no choice but to move ahead with this particular continental agenda. I say that there are no choice for a number of reasons. First, I'm not sure that there's any evidence of any country in the world that has achieved significant growth without taking advantage of the regional market. Maybe you have an example, unfortunately I do not have. All the countries that have achieved superlative growth, whether it is in Asia or is in North America, you would find eventually that they've achieved that growth partly based on the advantage they've taken of the regional market. So there's a historical reason why we should believe in this continental integration agenda. Secondly, there's also evidence that many of these countries have actually used the regional market as a stepping stone into the global market. And so we should not be surprised if we find that most of the world's advanced trading nations are also part of the most integrated regional economies. So this is a lesson for us to understand and appreciate on the continent.